avoid fault-finding mentality, because that's one of the things that has been programmed in the minds of so many mother-in-laws. Mm. You find you have a fault-finding mentality. If you want to win your daughter-in-law, win her through affirming her, then correcting her in love, if really that has to be. But let it come after you have actually praised her. I like the way you have kept this room. I see my son is getting big. You know, say something, because positive. There must be something positive that this girl has done. Just look for something and magnify that. However, I wish you can do 1, 2, 3 things. Just like a suggestion. It is not like you are forcing her to do. Let everything that you speak as a mother-in-law be in the form of suggestions. Because suggestion, you are giving me a leeway. I can either do it or not do it fully, or do it a little, and that will not offend you. So limits are very important, and that must be in your mind. You must clear your mind that now you are in someone's home. Even if it's a rental place, respect that one bedroom. You get to the point.
Yes, yes.
Respect it.
Yes.
And don't have a problem at it, because you can go anywhere. You can even get, you know, towel in their bedroom, because they have delayed to give you. I think that mannerism is very important, because that is what is going to make your son know that you respect him for having married. And this is what is going to make also the wife respect them,
respect
the mother-in-law,
yes.
Because you have the boundaries. So for me, I would say this, let every mother-in-law be guided by, you know, please, what would not want to be done, don't do it also. Just like your daughter-in-law cannot come and enter in your bedroom,
yes,
just after you are married,
yes,
you know, she needs to create that rapport,
yeah,
until you are so used to each other,
yes,
such that even when you send me to your bedroom, it is out of your own will. You get that.
Mm-hmm.
Eh? So boundaries are very, 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 very important. Otherwise, if you don't put that, you're going to have conflict right from day one. And this lady, you are going to stay with her 70, 80 years that they are going to stay with the husband. So at the end of the day, you are making your life hard,
yeah,
for yourself.
Miserable for yourself.
Miserable for yourself.
Because you are also getting old.
Oh yes, you are getting
no
old.
No one will help you.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's what you find when there is commotion.
Mm.
When there is commotion before even your son or your daughter have children, you find even when they get children, they don't want to come home.
Yeah.
Because they know mama yetu,
the mentality they have,
ni mama wa kusumbua, atakuja kutusumbua, atakuja kusema hii haifai, hii haifai. Even if it is food, eat the way it has been cooked by your daughter-in-law. Then you can tell her, I wish you can put some little salt, some little food, you know, oil. You know, correct her after you have already appreciated her and affirmed her.
In a good way.
Mm-hmm. So there's a way you can still handle that matter and handle it with a lot of love and with a lot of concern, and you become a favorite to your daughter-in-law, and also impact the skills and experience you have for all these years of that years to your daughter-in-law. But now you find, because of feeling like you own your son,
yes,
you know, feeling like he belongs to you, even if he's married,
yes,
I have the right to do what. That is what makes you now to have conflict, because you are behaving like a poor wife instead of behaving like a mother-in-law.